Hi, welcome back to Close Up. Let's get a snapshot on where things stand in the 2016 race from two very well-respected members of their respective parties, former Senator Judd Gregg, as well as Lou Feldstein. Good to see you this morning. Mr. Feldstein, we'll start with you. On the Democratic side of things, do you really believe Hillary is in as much trouble as it would seem that she is with the poll numbers?
She's hurting. She hasn't overcome the computer problem at all. On the other hand, she's got this deep national base, reaches all kinds of demographics, has a huge national organization, and while the others are mostly focusing on these two states, New Hampshire and Iowa, she's out there building a huge national organization with the hope that she can get past this, and come Super Tuesday, she'll win all the southern votes, plus maybe Michigan, Ohio, and have a chance to put it away despite all the doubts.
Yeah. Well, it's a dogfight here in New Hampshire, for sure, to say the least. It was probably one they weren't expecting.
That's a polite term, yeah. Dogfight.
On the flip side of that, Senator, is everybody else in the Republican Party is in as much trouble as it seems with one Donald Trump continuing to dominate the conversation?
Well, there's no question that Trump is dominating the conversation, but I don't think that that's going to push everybody else out of the race as we go into the primary. Right now, this is summer. When people go into the polling place, they get very serious about their vote. They don't want to throw it away. They're not going to vote for somebody who they don't think can govern. So I think there's four or five other candidates in this race who are very serious and who will be there certainly through the New Hampshire primary and probably for a while longer.
If the Donald Trump phenomenon is a sugar high, it has been sustained for a while now. Who do you believe will be standing toward the end, and will Donald Trump be one of them?
Well, I think it's premature to say because things are so unpredictable right now, but I suspect Trump will be one of them. I suspect Jeb Bush, John Kasich, maybe Carson or Fiorina, one of those two, probably not both of them. And then there could be a dark horse coming up on the outside. I suppose Kasich meets that criteria, but there's some other quality people like Marco Rubio, for example, and Chris Christie.
Just to ask the Senator a question. What do you make of, though, just the deep unhappiness and distrust by a big section of America that Trump and Bernie Sanders are carrying? Are we going to keep that going? Can we deal with that? What's going to happen on that in the election?
It really worries me because I still subscribe to the view that governing is very tough, a very difficult job, and that you need people who are willing to take on complex issues and discuss them substantively, and we're not getting that. What we're getting today is Duck Dynasty one-liners from some of these candidates, and people are getting their information from social media where there's no credibility as to the integrity of the information. So this is very concerning because we're a huge country and we're the most important nation in the world when it comes to the world peace and maintaining world stability, and you can't govern with one-liners. You've got to govern from being able to reach out and bring together consensus, and I'm a little concerned that that's not going to happen.
We have a couple of minutes to go, and I want to talk about the debates and the importance of them in the cycle. Obviously, there's going to be few of them. I start with you, Mr. Feldstein. Right now, it appears the Democratic debate here in New Hampshire will happen sometime in the days leading up to the holidays. Is that a good idea? On the part of the DNC, you think, or is that intentional on the part of the DNC, do you think?
I don't know enough about these insights, but it looks like they're managing it to protect Hillary's incumbency, as it were.
Sure. I mean, the optic, the way it is now, and does Joe Biden change that?
If Joe Biden gets in, it might change it. I think the pressure will build, and they'll have to do something different. I think what will happen if Univision goes in with the 93% of the Hispanics in America paying attention to that, if they decide to do a debate, what happens if New Hampshire does its own like they did in 2007? They won't be able to stop the candidates. People want to talk about this. I'm coming back to this issue that I think Trump is on. There's a lot of unhappiness in America, and we haven't found a way to deal with that, and that's really troubling.
And that brings us to the last point. How important do you believe, Senator, are these debates, which a lot of people say are nothing more but political theater, but you think at least it will bring out some substance of these candidates rather than the Duck Dynasty soundbites, as you put it?
I think they're critical. I think the fact that 24 million people watched the first debate is startling, and it shows that people are really engaged, they really want to listen, they want to know what's going on, they want to find out who these candidates are and whether they should be president of the United States. So I think they're absolutely critical.
24 million people, and you can say what you want to about them, but Donald Trump probably had a hand in those eyeballs.
Absolutely. He brings people to the table who aren't involved in the process already, and that's actually constructive.
All right, gentlemen, we'll see what happens. We are in the home stretch, kind of. Come back anytime, we'll talk about it.
Sounds good. Thank you.
Good to see you.